Lewisburg Jubilee Library, in conjunction with Wildflowers Institute founder Ms. Cassandra Richardson, presents Reading Freaks Me Out. This book discussion on everything, everything is written by Nicola Yoon. The director, the focal group, and the supportive team of the Phillipsburg Jubilee Library decided to discuss this interesting novel. Before this book discussion, 20 dynamic youngsters were asked to read portions which were also recorded. Now, we are going to discuss the book. The discussion will be centered around the following topics. 1. All types of relationships that occurred in this novel. 2. Risk. Should we take them? When should we take them? Why not? 3. Fantasy versus reality. And 4. Domestic abuse. We are looking forward to an in-depth discussion in which all these topics will be dealt with within detail. I'd like to introduce you to the facilitator of the book discussion. We know her in the community as the former executive director of the Safe Haven Foundation. She is a tireless agent for social change in addressing domestic violence. Cassandra has her master's degree in social work from the University of Windsor in Windsor, Ontario, Canada. We invite her to facilitate this discussion because her clinical work experience working in mental health with children and teens at the Windsor Regional Hospital and for her experience in developing psychosocial programs for teens. I now give the floor to Ms. Cassandra Richardson.
So I'd like to go on to risks.
Yes.
Shall we just discuss risks now? All right, so that's topic number 2. What were some of the risks taken by some of the characters in the book? So we can start with Maddie. Who wants to discuss that? All right, go ahead, Akela.
So, as we all know, Maddie was isolated because of her mom for many years.
Mm-hmm.
Really, she started to become more connected with the outer world when Ollie moved in next door.
Mm-hmm.
And it was from that relationship that she started keeping secrets from her mom. And that was a risk because she kept talking to Ollie and she had no knowledge about that. And as her relationship with Ollie progressed, he actually came over into her house, and mm-hmm. that was a risk.
Okay.
She was risking her health, and Carla, the nurse, was facilitating that
right.
meetup, so she was partly responsible.
Okay.
And another risk that Maddie took was when she was playing phonetic Scrabble with her mom,
mm-hmm.
and they heard arguments outside, and she saw that Ollie was in
right.
trouble.
And she ran outside,
and
right? Even after
outside.
Her mom told her not to. And she thought that she was sick. But you said the first risk. I didn't even think about that being a risk, right? So for her to hide stuff from her mom. And you said that that was a risk. Why was that a risk? Why do you think that that was a risk?
For me, that was a risk.
Uh-huh.
Because when children or teenagers hide things from their parents,
mm-hmm.
in the event that anything were to happen to the teenagers, then the parents would have no knowledge about it. And that it could end, you know, pretty badly.
Yeah, it could end pretty badly. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Anything else? Yeah, go ahead.
I would say in relation to risks,
mm-hmm.
I feel like it was a butterfly effect, if that makes sense. I think the risk factor started with Madeline's mom
mm-hmm.
having to keep her inside. And I think from there, it just spiraled into more and more risks and more choices that seemed more risk and would affect more people detrimentally in the long run.
Okay.
So I think that was my observation from
okay.
the risk perspective.
Okay. How about the risks that Ollie took? What sort of risks did Ollie take?
So, I think Ali took the biggest risk of all in the whole story because, as somebody said, I don't know if it was you or Disha, that they had a toxic relationship. Mm-hmm. He, his sister, his father. The father would abuse the mother physically, mentally. It would have effect on the sister, Ali, everybody. Mm-hmm. Ali left the place. He left where he was, California, L.A.?
Yeah, California.
Okay, he left California with Maddie to Hawaii.
Yes.
Leaving the father alone with the mother and the daughter.
Yes.
Not knowing what could happen. He could, you know, he's a drunk, so he could kill them. He could beat them both sick. I find that was the biggest risk he took, like trusting. No, he needed a break. So he trusted that, he basically trusted that the father wouldn't do anything.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. How about Carla? Did Carla take any risks? I'm looking over here because there's a contention here between whether Carla was good or bad or whether she didn't know her place as a nurse and a caretaker. Did she take a risk?
She took a risk, and I do not feel that she was good or bad. I just feel that, and if you say that way, that she did take that risk. And it was good that she encouraged Maddie to live because you either get busy dying or you get busy living. So I'm happy that she did do that.
Okay.
However, a conversation that should be held with adults should have been taking place, not you speaking to the child with certain things, because the risk there was Maddie started lying to her mother. Now, it was not that Carla said to do that, but she started telling lies. And she also brought in a boy into the home. Whether or not the home was supposed to be a secure home, yes or no, you as an adult should not encourage a teenager or any child or whatever to do something that is outside of the norm of within a home setting, because this is your home. This is not that person's home. So you have to know your boundaries. So which part, the risk of saying, where the mother said she should have been your nurse and not your friend. That was really important for me as an adult, as a mother, because you should know your boundaries. Now, I do understand where the nurse took the risk because she wanted Maddie to live, and I would applaud her there. So I hope I'm not contradicting myself there, but I feel that she should have had a conversation still with the mother.
How do you think that we could have still seen the protagonist, Maddie, take that risk, but still it being okay with how the nurse facilitated that risk? What should the nurse have done? Or what could she have done differently? Or could she have done anything differently?
I don't know.
Maybe it was...
I don't think she could have, because based on the mother, she probably would not have. So it was a good thing on what she did.
Yeah.
I just feel that...
and that's what risks are, right?
Yeah.
I think that that's what risks are, that you have to go against something conventional in order to risk something.
Yes. True.
But they could be mitigated, I guess. I don't know. Maybe she could have done something different. I don't know.
Because if this thing had played out real wrong, if the book was written differently and something had really happened to Maddie, she would have ended up not loving herself as the nurse.
Yeah, her guilt would
have been. Her guilt would have played a major role. Now, the book spin off nicely in the end, that nothing took place, etc. But you don't know. Sometimes you don't know within risk what could happen. I'm not saying you shouldn't take risk, because you need to know what is going to happen at the other side of the story, within your own life story. However.
Okay.
I think we have to really work that one out.
Okay. Go ahead, Disha.
I think that if it had happened that Carla decided not to bring Ollie into the house, it wouldn't have resulted in a lack of risk. I feel like even if she made a decision not to bring Ollie in, they would have found a way to be together and create even more risk. And in that way, she put herself as an intermediary so that she can, like we said, facilitate monitor.
That's an interesting way of looking at it, for sure, right? So that the risk was still mitigated.
Right.
So she probably knew, as being a teenager, as some teenagers may do, is that they will, like the heart wants what the heart wants, right? And you will do whatever it is that you want to do or feel to do, but maybe perhaps the nurse recognized that she's gonna do it anyway, so I might as well take the risk and facilitate that meeting so that she is safe. We could look at it that way. That's a really good, insightful way of looking at it too, Disha. Yeah. Team Carla, sorry. Team Carla.
It's just about the lie.
The lie,
because even at the point when she risked running away.
At which point?
Maddie ran away.
Oh, when she went to Hawaii?
Before she went to Hawaii, she stopped by Carla.
Yep.
And then she risked lying about the pills. And then Carla knew about the lie. There was a lot of lying take place based on this risk. I mean, I can understand that she facilitated everything in the beginning. You know, but if you put on bread and you leave it outside for a while, it's left there to fester, and the lie and the lies continue and the lies continue. And I'm not saying, let me cut the mother out of it. Let me say, if it was a normal relationship, would we really want that?
Would the nurse really do that if it was a normal relationship?
Was it a fantasy at that point?
I don't know, but we'll discuss fantasy and reality in a little bit. Okay. But how do we feel, the risk, right? So the risk, so we remember when, before Maddie was going to Hawaii, and she stopped at Carla. And I thought that was beautiful too. I'm so sorry.
I love that part.
So that was her caretaker. She wanted to see her caretaker, and her caretaker knew about these pills that weren't true. How did we feel about that?
I feel like she was a real one, for like, you know, because Ollie didn't know, but she basically she didn't even suspect it. Like, they talked to each other with their minds. Like, Maddie gave her that look.
They were kindred spirits. Like,
she was a real one for not telling Ollie, because at the end of the day, that's like her daughter. She wanted to see her doing her best. You know, she wanted to see her happy. She already outside. Ain't nothing more you could do about it. I understood.
So she was like, might as well go. Yeah. You might as well go and just take care of yourself, really.
About what you said, Atlanta, about Carla sort of being a mom, right? And her being a real one for lying to Ollie. Because I don't know. So I feel like some people consider lying to be deceiving others. And that's done whether you say something or you don't, like you withhold information. So with Carla withholding the information about Ollie coming to the house from the mom, and her doing the same thing about withholding information from Ollie about the pills, it can be concluded that it's okay for moms or mother figures to, you know, let a lie slide or just lie a little bit. You know.
Team who now? Team who?
Team Carla for life. But
Team Carla for life. But Carla's also human, right?
Yeah, she is.
So, I mean, as being human, you're fallible, right? So you make mistakes. That's what the whole thing about being human is all about. But we develop the skills around our being fallible to make it better, right? Mm-hmm. So we develop those skills, both around the lying and the risk-taking, and, you know, we try to do that more responsibly, right? But by also encouraging people to live and be happy and be challenged and grow. Mm-hmm. And Miss Powell is looking at me very disapprovingly. So.
No. I do believe in the fact that you have to grow. I do believe that, but not based on a lie. and not based on deceiving someone else. Imagine your life is based on a lie.
But don't you think that some people, but the mom lied. So sometimes you have to take those risks.
So are you trying to say this whole book is just based on lies?
It actually is.
Well, it is. Well, I don't know. Okay, so you know what was a poignant quote as well? Life is a gift. Don't forget to live it. Who said that?
Carla.
Team Carla. Shakira, you had something to say.
I'm going to speak in general.
Yes. All right.
Even so being the case, if everybody does lie, maybe is a reason why teens is lies specifically.
Okay. Talk a little bit about that. We want to get to the next topic, but I need to hear this. So teens lie? Well, everybody lies.
Everybody lies. I'm not going to say I don't lie.
But you're saying that teens lie. Okay.
You understand? But okay. We lie based on the fact of how our parents are.
Okay.
And we probably don't want the backlash. We don't want the confrontation. We just do. We just do without saying. Or we just do without, you know, how to put it? We don't think about the consequences.
The consequences.
Maybe we do. We just don't want to input our parents because they know it all.
Okay.
You understand? But it's not to say that we want to lie. It's just their perception of how they will take, how they're going to handle what we're about to say. And that's why we'd be like, that's why I ain't saying nothing in the first place.
Right. Oh, okay. So it's the backlash and it's the reaction from parents.
Exactly.
That you think that's why teens misrepresent the truth.
True.
Not lie, but misrepresent the truth in order to, because they're going to do what they're going to do anyway. Yeah. That's like people, I guess, you know.
So what you're saying is, we as teens take the risk of lying in order to avoid the risk of our parents reacting in a way that we wouldn't want it to be.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So I think there's another quote, another saying, ask for forgiveness and not permission. I think that's it. Ask for forgiveness and not permission in order for you to do what it is that you have to do. Mm-hmm. But parents have a responsibility in order to guide, right? So I think that it's about making the space safe, mm-hmm. right, for teens to talk about stuff with their parents.
Yes.
So don't react, respond, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. I think that's it. Any last words? Any last words about that? Okay, so then there's another quote. Will I encounter turbulence? Yes. Into all lives, a little turbulence must fall. How does that bring risk into the equation? Quickly now.
You have to take risks.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure the book says something along the lines of not taking risks is a risk.
Not taking risk is a, yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
So
yes. A risk of not living.
Right.
Yes. Right? Or not living fully. That was also a good quote, yeah.
And I think it ties in as well to what Carla said about living
mm-hmm.
and regretting. I'm sorry, I can't remember the code verbatim.
I think somebody had that.
You're not living if you're not.
That was
you're not living if you're not regretting.
Oh, you're not living if you're not regretting. Yes. Yeah.
Right.
You're not
right.
living yes. if you're not regretting.
And I think that turbulence would be referring to the regrets or yeah. what you'd have to go through in order to regret.
Yeah.
So I think that is a very good way to think about life and what we have to go through to grow.
Right, right. Mm-hmm. No, that was a good one. Does anybody else could bring up maybe a quote or something about risks?
I have a quote about risks that I love.
Oh, okay.
So it says, everything is a risk, not doing anything is a risk. It's up to you.
Okay.
So basically it's saying You live your life how you want to live.
Yeah.
If you feel the path going to be hard, you still want to do it, you take that part.
Right.
No matter, even if you know you're going to fall,
yeah,
you might get up.
Right.
As I take from that. I love that. I love
okay.
that.
Okay.
There's a wonderful song that I love
mm-hmm.
Based on risk.
Okay.
I mean, it's from my age group, I think. From Dionne Warwick, and it came in the show from Madea. Mm-hmm. And it said, of the family that prays, and it said, I hope you dance. So don't leave life pass you by,
mm-hmm.
I hope you dance. Because at the end of the day, you have to take risk, as was said in the group, that for us to grow. However, please remember, don't just take risk that can cause you to suffer,
mm-hmm.
in my opinion.
Right.
Briefly, I want to state that there was another quote said something along the lines of making decisions.
Mm-hmm.
When you have to make a decision, you will never know if it's the right or wrong one. Sometimes mm-hmm. it's just hard to tell the difference.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's just hard to tell the difference.
Okay.
Yeah. Anything else on risk? I'd like to say just a little bit about that quote that you mentioned. You know, and that's a pursuance of happiness too, right?
Mm-hmm.
So not everybody's happiness is the same as everybody else's.
Mm-hmm.
And if you decide not to take that risk to pursue your happiness, no matter if it might be tough, right? So maybe you have to go through lots of things that you didn't necessarily want to go through
mm-hmm.
in order for you to get to the goal of that happiness, you wouldn't be happy. Right? And then there's also a happiness in the pursuance, so in the progress, in the journey of pursuing that goal, right? So that I think that people who want to be happy, they need to do that. So mm-hmm. there's a risk, there's absolutely a risk in not taking risks mm-hmm. either.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. This is such an interesting book. It was really, really, really such a cool book.
We hope that you enjoyed our program, Reading Freaks Me Out. Join us for the next segment in the program. Thank you for listening and also viewing.